That southpaw stance, Jordan Lucas fighting out of the orthodox. This fight is brought to you by Kandaji Palace Hotel. Lucas is in white, Saadulaev is in black. Peter, what you got?
They're both taking it very easy. The feeling out process is underway at the moment. Southpaw versus orthodox fighter. This could be very interesting. You know, when you train to fight against an unorthodox fighter, so someone that's in southpaw, you have different strikes available to you. You have different things you got to watch out for. You've always got to watch out for that lead right hand, which works as a nice overhand hook, which just flies over the top of your left jab when you throw it out. So you got to be very careful. But they are very susceptible to taking body shots from the orthodox right leg.
That's a big leg kick. You can see the welt starting to develop on the inside of Lucas's left leg there. You can just see the welts. Man, it is so painful to get hit in that leg. Yes, they do hurt right then, but it definitely pays dividends later in the fight when those leg kicks start to wear into you.
The damage mounts up and it gets harder and harder to walk, let alone strike. And that's what he's gonna be having to do a lot of towards the end of this round. You know, to get more damage, you know, away from his leg there. He might want to change stance, I don't know. But at the moment, he seems to be quite confidently walking forward, and they're throwing strikes to the lab, is going in for a takedown, but he gets stuffed.
Good takedown defense by Lucas. Lucas is an Australian Muay Thai champion, and Saadulaev says he wants to consistently be moving and not let Jordan Lucas get comfortable in his striking.
The arena is really enjoying this fight. Everyone here is shouting. Oh, Saadulaev has just, he's gone for a takedown after tripping up and going backwards, but they're both on their feet again. The arena, as I said, is really enjoying this fight. The atmosphere here is electric.
Yeah, that was a kind of a sloppy attempt by Saadulaev to jump into the takedown. He's really got to be a little bit more smooth coming in with his strikes and setting up that takedown a lot better than that. He does train with the featherweight champion here at ONE Championship. Murat Gafurov is a close friend and also in his corner right now.
Oh, look at that. What a knockdown. That was a fantastic knockdown. That just rocked Lucas's world for a moment there. Now Gafurov is, Saadulaev is trying to pass the guard of Jordan Lucas. He's got one foot hooked in, has Jordan, so it's going to be pretty tricky. I can't see what's happening on the other side there. It looks like he's trying to get
a bit of a crucifix position there, but Jordan Lucas fights his way out of that.
Fixed in position there, yeah. George Lucas has that leg, so he can't get in the crucifix from that position there. Lucas said he wanted to be on the ground with Saadulaev. However, I think he preferred to be on top rather than underneath Yusup Saadulaev, as you know, Yusup has pretty good wrestling and he's going to utilize that right now.
He's trying to slide his leg out, but now he ends up in side control. But Lucas is fighting to try. Now he's in the crucifix position, and this is a world of pain for Lucas to be in as Saadulaev starts to rain down those punches. He's got the arm trapped on both sides, but Lucas manages to fight his way out of it.
He broke free there. Luckily, he was absorbing those punches. There was nothing much he could do. He had nothing, no limbs to block with. He's pushing on the hips. He's trying to keep the legs of Saadulaev between his. He's trying to get that guard back. He's got one knee in right now, and he's got the foot across the back. He's pulling Saadulaev down with a clinch from his back. Is that going to be enough? Saadulaev is now in Jordan's, well, he's just passed Jordan's guard. He's gone off to the side control, and now he's working to full mount position.
Wow, Peter, like a hot knife through butter. He just slid through that guard of Jordan Lucas, and now he's attempting. Oh, beautiful jump over pass. Oh, he's got a choke in.
My, that is
Wow,
that was fantastic. He put so much pressure on there. He had so much leverage. That is a black belt choke. I've had that done to me before. It really is horrible. Unfortunately, our purple belt, Jordan Lucas, was outclassed again today in Myanmar. Maybe this is not his lucky country.
Wow, Peter, that was a tremendous choke. He jumped over like a ninja into the back of Jordan Lucas. Take a look at this, Peter. Talk us through it.
He hits the cage, rolls off the cage, pulls down on that choke. It is so tight, and he tries to get his hips as far back as possible to put the pressure on. He knew it was in. It was just a case of how long he had to hold on. And Jordan Lucas reluctantly taps. Oh, he really didn't want to tap there. But
look at this.
No choice.
He runs up the cage like a ninja in the night to lock in that.
Your winner by way of submission, Yusup Saadulaev.
I don't know, Peter. That could have been the AGD fight of the night with that beautiful running up the cage wall into a modified rear naked choke for the win for Yusup Saadulaev.